these burning crosses. I mean, how did you feel standing there? I mean,
you know, I'm not fearful of those people. You know, they thrive on fear, which is why they're still around today.
I mean, for instance, you brought the robes out here. I mean, what, did they give these to you?
They gave these to me when they quit. This here is...
And how many folks have you got to quit?
Directly, probably about 20, 24.
So. Really?
But indirectly, a couple hundred, more than a couple hundred. Because this right here is an imperial wizard's robe. An imperial wizard is a national leader, okay? And
you got an imperial wizard to quit?
That's right. This is his robe. He gave it to me when he quit. He and I became the best of friends. All right. And when he quit, his whole clan, which consisted of a little over 200 members, dissolved. Dissolved.
Wow.
Today, there is no more organized Ku Klux Klan in the state of Maryland.
What about this one?
Blue or purple is the imperial color.
Okay.
Okay. Green is the grand level, I mean state level. Grand Dragon will wear this. This was a Grand Dragon's robe. Okay, and you have your choice of cotton with green adornments, a green cape, etc. See the dragon patch here, green sash. That means state leader, Grand Dragon. All right? Or you can have a full green satin robe. Okay, cotton or satin is your own personal choice. Green is Grand Dragon. This is a Grand Dragon from another clan group, another state leader. All right, this guy, he was in prison for 3 years for conspiring to bomb a synagogue up in Baltimore, Maryland, okay? Then he got out.
And there's a picture of him right here.
That's him right there, okay? And when he got out, he continued running the Klan, and then he got busted again, went to prison for 4 years for assault with intent to murder two black men with a shotgun. Now, as a Klan leader, you get a stipend, not enough to live on, pay your mortgage, right? You have to have a day job, right? His day job, while he's trying to bomb the synagogue, trying to shoot these two black men, his day job was Baltimore City police officer.
Wow.
Okay? He was not an undercover cop in the Klan. He was a Klan in the police department. You got me?
Wow.
Okay?
And so that guy gave you...
He went on to become one of my best friends, which is why I now own his robe and his uniform. Because I toured the country giving a lot of lectures on racism and things like that.
You detail all of his experiences in your book.
I do.
Folks, Daryl, first of all, one hell of a story.
Thank you.
I mean, yeah, I'm sure you're great at identifying it. The book is called Clandestine Relationships.
All right, people. When it comes to the Klan, we're going to just say no. No more. We not having it. We not going for it. It's 2015. It's about unity, peace, and love, family. J10, over and out. Peace.